TV3, Wilmington, North Carolina.
Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy won't be seen tonight, so we may bring you the Colonial Athletic Association Tournament semifinal game between UNCW and Navy. Now let's go live to the Patriot Center in Fairfax, Virginia for the player introductions and tonight's game.
Meet the starters for tonight's first game between the Seahawks of UNC Wilmington and the Midshipmen of Navy. At guard for the Seahawks of the University of North Carolina at Wilmington, a 6'2" junior from Chapel Hill, North Carolina, number 22, a Sandy Anderson. At guard for the Midshipmen of Navy, a 6'1" junior from Wheeling, West Virginia, number 10, Doug Wojcik. At guard for the Seahawks, 6'1" senior from Grand Rapids, Michigan, and number 11, Bobby Joe Springer. At guard for Navy, a 6'6" senior from Lebanon, Oregon, and number 5, Kyler Whitaker. At center for Wilmington, a 6'9" junior from Columbia, North Carolina, and number 25 is Brian Rousham. At center for Navy, a 6'11" junior from Woodbridge, Virginia, number 50, David Robinson. At forward for the Seahawks, a 6'6" freshman from Fremont, Ohio, number 33, Greg Bender. At forward for Navy, 6'6" junior from Floyd's Knob, Indiana, number 40, Carl Liebert. At forward for Wilmington, a 6'5" junior from Fayetteville, North Carolina, number 31, Charles Cherry. And at forward for Navy, 6'7" senior from Beltsville, Maryland, number 51, Vernon Butler. North Carolina at Wilmington is coached by Mel Gibson. His assistants are Jim Trivett and Lee Hood. Navy's coached by Paul Evans. His assistants are Pete Herman, John Fitzpatrick, Dave Layton, and Al Morens. Your officials for tonight's
North Carolina
first
Wilmington
game.
Beat East Carolina in first round play, 75-54 in Wilmington on Saturday to advance to the semifinals. And Navy beat James Madison 81-67. The Middies bring an 11-game win streak, and they've also won 18 of their last 19 coming into this game.
That's not a bad record. They've got a fine basketball team, as we've seen them play quite a few times this year. But, you know, in a tournament like this, anything can happen. And I'm sure Coach Evans is worried and hope the team is fired up and play to their capabilities.
The officials tonight are Hank Armstrong, John Bunder, and Bob Barnett. The first of two semifinal games to be seen here on Home Team Sports. And there are the matchups, the 1-2 punch for Navy, David Robinson and Vernon Butler. Brian Rousham, the main man for the Seahawks. He is their all-time leading rebounder and third all-time scorer in UNC Wilmington history. And here's the way the first two games went during the regular season. Navy winning both, 76-61 and 95-68. So they had very little trouble with UNC Wilmington during the regular season. And the Middies control the tip. This is playmaker Doug Wojcik, junior from Wheeling, West Virginia, the all-time leading assist man in Navy's history.
See, they have started out in a peculiar defense. It's a diamond and one.
Vernon Butler misses the shot. David Robinson gets fouled.
They opened in a diamond and one that time, Mel, with Brian Rousham guarding David Robinson man-to-man, which is, you know, you don't want to get Rousham in foul trouble either, but that was the defense that they opened in.
Foul is on Sandy Anderson of UNC Wilmington. The Seahawks will have to keep their eye on this man, Kyler Whitaker, who is a deadly outside shooter. Doug Wojcik fills it up. He normally doesn't take many shots.
Well, not this early in the game, that's for sure. You know, normally he waits until the other team gives him something and really makes it just almost unbelievable that he has to take it, but that's a good sign for Navy.
Bobby Joe Springer in the backcourt along with Sandy Anderson. This is Anderson, two little guards. Anderson at 6'2". Springer listed at 6'1". I'm not sure he's quite that tall. And up front they go with Charles Cherry, Greg Bender, and Brian Rousham. This is Bender, the fine freshman from Fremont, Ohio. Robinson shuts off Charles Cherry. Boy, he can move quickly. Rousham with his first field goal attempt. Not a particularly good shot. And a rebound to Carl Liebert. Clears it out to Wojcik.
He was trying for the foul that time, but referees didn't call it.
Butler, who loves to use that muscle inside. That's his pet shot. That turnaround jumper. It's good to go to the free throw line.
You know, he's amazing the way he can use his body. We can see it here. They keep going to him the second time, and watch as he turns. He just leans right in the defensive player, and, you know, all of his calls, they all mostly could be called charge on him just about.
Vernon Butler coming into the game has scored 1,839 points. He's also 1,000 in rebounds. If he misses the free throw, Navy leading 4-0.
Navy's defense is, for them, is perfect against UNCW. Wilmington likes to play against man-to-man. They don't
steal by Whitaker ahead to Doug Wojcik, and it is 6-0, Navy.
Like I was saying, they don't really like to play against zones. They're great. They do a heck of a job against man-to-man because they're very well disciplined, and Bobby Joe can handle the ball so well.
And Robinson almost had a steal, but showing his athletic ability there. Paul Evans was saying, Bob, that in gymnastics courses at the Naval Academy, they use Robinson to demonstrate the various tricks. That's how skilled he is as an athlete. He can walk on his hands.
He sure is a fine athlete. There's no question about that.
Probably can walk on water, too. Brian Rousen connects on the baseline jumper.
Navy's looking to push the ball down the court every time. That's, of course, that's a trademark of theirs. They like to run.
Kyler Whitaker. Short. Robinson over the top for the rebound.
Well, you're going to have to block him off the boards. That's kind of a long rebound, but somebody should be definitely in front of him every time.
You got help.
Navy really doing a good job on Rossum inside. .17:30 remaining in the first half. Navy leads 8-2.
Wilmington's being smart here. There's no need for them to be in a hurry. They need to get some good shots and try to stay in this game early.
Greg Bender from deep in the corner. Robinson with a good block out. He's second the country in rebounding, leads the nation in block shots. Butler muscling his way in. Might have been fouled.
Well, Hank Armstrong was right there, and he said no foul. I kind of like it. It's good no call as far as I'm concerned.
And we've got a timeout on the court with seven.
Here in Southport, people really know how to relax. And here in Hempstead, people know how to relax. The people of Wilmington? Well, they know how to relax, too. You see, all these folks have heard about the individual retirement accounts at People's Federal. And they're dropping by and opening IRAs to save on taxes and earn tax-deferred interest so they can be ready for retirement. Hi. And so they can relax now. Avoid the tax rush by opening your IRA at People's Federal today and relax.
Welcome to Wells Oldsmobile in Whiteville. There's excitement in the air because we have one of the largest selection of Oldsmobiles, GMC trucks, and Jeeps in our history. Now is the time to start planning your vacation while you can choose from our big stock of Oldsmobiles, GMC pickups, safari vans, and customized vans. Also, the versatile lineup of Jeep wagons, CJ7s, and the four-wheeler of the year, our all-new Jeep Comanche. We take pride in helping you select the new car of your choice at Wells Oldsmobile, right in the heart of Whiteville.
Navy is the home team in this first game. Mel Proctor with Bob Talbot at the Patriot Center in Fairfax, Virginia. Navy with a six-point lead as play resumes. Bobby Joe Springer, the senior playmaker from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Sandy Anderson from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. Springer with his first field goal attempt. He had 12 points in the opening round victory over East Carolina.
I tell you, it's a good sign for Navy to see guys like David Robinson out trying to get a steal or so. You know they're really fired up, even though that time it caused an open shot. That kind of aggressiveness, though, will get you a lot of points down the end of the game.
Tyler Whitaker, that's his pet shot. Got tremendous range in that jump shot. What a game he had against Richmond as Navy won the regular season title. He had 8 or 9 consecutive shots in the first half. Springer, he's hit 2 in a row.
I think this is one of the few Navy weaknesses. They have a tendency to have spells where they don't play real tough defense. They'll play good tough defense for a while, but then they'll slack off.
Carl Liebrich with a baseline jumper. Robinson pushed off, and he picks up a foul.
Well, they are doing a good job of blocking him out. You can see here, they've got Cherry and Rousham are keeping him from going to the basket. He does use his hands a little bit to push off there.
First foul on David Robinson, and the first team foul on Navy. The Middies lead 10-6. Navy 25-4 coming into this game. They won the regular season title in the Colonial Athletic Association with a 13-1 record. They only lost to Richmond. Liebert with a rebound. Wojcik always looking for the open man, and there he is, Whitaker.
That's, I can't understand why a team, and I'm sure Coach Mel Gibson's saying the same thing. They run the same fast break. Whitaker goes down to the right corner. If he doesn't have there, he cuts all the way through. It should be able for the zone, easy for the zone to pick him up.
Navy has doubled the score on UNC Wilmington. Charles Cherry trying to get Robinson off his feet, and he shoots an air ball. Whitaker is open on a breakaway with Bender chasing him. Whitaker off a fast start with 6 of Navy's 14 points.
Great recognition that time of Carl Liebert to see Whitaker down the floor wide open. Made a nice out of the pass. The guards have got to get back quicker for North Carolina Wilmington. They can't get caught in under the basket.
Charles Cherry over Robinson.
Hey, that's the way they got to play. Take it right to him, and if he's going to block a shot, make him earn them.
Navy with a 6-point lead with 14:30 remaining in the half. Robinson backing in. And he draws the foul.
He got bumped pretty good there. Watch him how he moves here. Bender's down there on him. Now they switch out. Rassum tries to front him. And he gets bumped by Cherry and Rassum. So they're trying to be as physical as they can with him inside.
Fouls on Brian Rassum. Robinson rattles it in.
Well, that's what makes him so tough. Yeah, he's got a really nice soft touch for a guy that size. And, well, when you shoot a ball up that way, you know, it wasn't really a good shot, but the touch was so nice it stayed around and rolled in.
Mark Perry, number 15, is in the game for UNC Wilmington. Sophomore from Anderson, Indiana. He is a good outside shooter, and that's what they need right now, some outside shooting to loosen up that zone, because Navy's really packed it back in.
Navy will play zone 99% of the game. 100% unless they just have to go man-to-man.
Tough shot by Cherry. Robinson with a rebound. Wojcik pushes the ball up court. There's Whitaker in the corner. Inside to Vernon Butler over Cherry. Robinson with a slam.
He's going to call those in and on this.
Oh, my.
Well, I tell you what, it looked like it was way out of the cylinder.
Looked like a good shot to me, but it is nullified. Basket interference, and we've got a timeout with 13:37 remaining in the first half.
This is Don Kimble. It's that exciting time of year again. Basketball fever grips the Carolinas, and at Don Kimble Chevrolet, we've got even more excitement. 7.9% financing on Chevettes. Economical and sporty. 9.9% financing on most new 86 Chevrolet cars and trucks. Save hundreds now with this special financing. Remember, Don Kimble Chevrolet, 228 South College Road, the good people can save you money.
Woody, here's your expense money. And bring back a heavy hitter.
On your way to another town, you can't spend a lot, but you know how to get around. Avis makes it easy, easy on the traveler, yeah.
Avis tries harder. Our super value rates give you more for less.
Bush leads, college towns, sand lots, make the rounds.
Ryan, number two.
Avis makes it easy, easy on the traveler, yeah.
Woody, the kid's great. Who tipped you off?
His mother.
Avis, so easy.
When planning your family's meals, be sure to visit the meat department at Giant Food. You can always count on top quality and great values, plus the friendly service you've come to expect from Giant. Take a look at that play that was nullified, a spectacular slam dunk by David Robinson. I think he got the short end of this deal.
Yes, he did. Watch the ball bounce way out. He catches
a foot
from the basket, brings it back in. He can't even believe it. He just run down. He's already counted in his mind, and I'm like him. He says, holy cow, ref.
Strange call.
Well, it usually bounces out. They've got some good officials out there. Well, you see the difference on the board, 7-2 in favor of Navy.
Mark Gary with his first shot.
Yes, sir.
Need that.
He's a good shooter from out there, and they really need that outside shooting right now.
Berry has replaced Anderson at guard for UNC Wilmington. Wojcik looking for his shots in this first half. Cherry can't hold it. And it's Anderson who runs it down. Springer.
Oh,
what a shot by Sandy Anderson.
Well, he shot that almost lying on the floor.
UNC Wilmington really has three guards in there now. Mark Berry, Sandy Anderson, and Springer. I thought Anderson had gone out, but he's in there, and they're using three guards and the two big men, Rossum and Cherry. Well, that's not a very big lineup.
No, it's not, but offensively, they're a lot more powerful outside.
Wojcik. That's leaving him open.
That's more shots than Wojcik usually takes in a game. He's already taken three.
He's already hit his season's average.
I tell you, I'd like to see that, though. I think it makes Navy such a better team. You know, all he has to hit is 40, 45%, but at least take the shot, so you have to guard him.
Doug Wojcik has already scored 6 points. He's averaging only 5.4 per game. Navy leads 18-12. 12 minutes remaining in the first half. The winner of this game meets the winner of the Richmond George Mason contest for the title tomorrow night. You'll see the championship game here on Home Team Sports.
We haven't heard much from Brian Rousen so far. Navy's done a heck of a job on him inside.
We've got Butler fronting him as much as possible now on the zone.
Well,
there he is, Rousen.
There he is, finally.
His second field goal. He had 21 points, 18 rebounds in the opening round victory over East Carolina.
Take it. Wojcik, you're hot. Move back to him. He's hit two out of three.
Robinson on the miss. Rebound to Brian Rossum, the all-time leading rebounder in UNC Wilmington's history. 11-14 remaining in the first half. Navy's lead is 4 points, 18-14.
UNCW's playing a good game so far. They're not panicking at all. They were down quite a bit early, but they just cut away at it.
Rousham's
yes,
hit
sir.
Two in a row. Rousham averaged 20 points a game during the regular season.
Well, Navy's just allowing penetration too easy. You know, if you let somebody cut down the middle like that, it's easy to get the pass.
Vernon Butler can't put it down, but Liebert sneaks inside for the follow shot.
Well, that's the other end of playing three guards. You know, that really hurts your rebounding.
Navy with a much bigger lineup with Robinson, Butler, and Liebert out there along with the two guards. And one of those guards, Whitaker, is bigger than any of the three UNC Wilmington guards. Sandy Anderson connects for the Seahawks.
They're not playing good defense tonight now. Their zone is not very active at all. They're giving up penetration easy and a lot of easy outside shots.
Kyler Whitaker, that silky smooth jump shot. He's got 8 points.
You don't see Whitaker too many times put the ball on the floor like that to take his jumper. Usually he likes to shoot from a standing position, but he looked good on that one.
Whitaker's getting into one of those streaks. He's hit his last four shots. In his last 10 games, he shot 56% from the floor. Sandy Anderson is fouled as he goes to the basket. A push called on Carl Liebert of Navy. That's his first foul and the second team foul on the middies.
You know, one of the bad things, I guess, of having a real good offense team like Navy is that some nights, you know, that the defensive intensity is just not there. But the players feel they're going to outscore the other team anyway, so, you know, they really don't put out 100% on defense. And as a coach, that really bothers you.
UNC Wilmington is an outstanding free throw shooting team. As a team, they are 13th in the country, shooting 75%.
Well, that's excellent, 75% for a whole team.
Sandy Anderson makes one out of two, and David Robinson has another rebound. It's 22-19 Navy, 9:40 remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington trying to spring an upset, maybe the top seed in this tournament.
Well, here you see a man-to-man. Now Wilmington.
Springer with those quick hands picks Kyler Whitaker clean.
First time tonight they showed that. And it surprised Navy.
Greg Bender, 33, has come back in for UNC Wilmington, replacing Mark Gary. Springer on the baseline drive, tries to hand it to Cherry. The ball stripped away. Butler rolls it to Whitaker.
Yes, sir. That was
Wojcik open but passes up the shot.
Vernon Butler made that play. He got on the floor and nobody else would. And everybody was reaching for it except for him.
He's that kind of a player. He'll dive for loose balls, go to the seats. Whitaker misses the shot. Liebert in there battling, but Sandy Anderson has it. Here come the Seahawks.
We've got a 5-on-2.
Anderson, great pass to Bender, who hits the shot and he's fouled.
Yes, sir. So that's what it's so obvious to me that the intense defensive intensity is just not there. You see this time, all five women players were down the court and only two Navy players.
Carl Liebert picks up his second foul, the 13th foul on Navy, and UNC Wilmington has a chance to tie it as Bender goes to the free throw line. He's a 76% shooter. All-stater from Fremont, Ohio. We saw him before, and he plays with more points than you would expect for a freshman.
He sure does. He is a very heady ball player.
Three-point play for Bender ties the score at 22.
It's funny, Coach Gibson said they had no idea that he would start or be that good, but said from the first day of practice, he just established himself, and he started every game.
And the Seahawks now play more aggressively on defense and extending their defense.
Now they've gone to man-to-man. They're really putting a lot of pressure on Navy.
Butler over Bender. It counts, and there's a foul.
Boy, I think he might have missed one here. Oh, Vernon, watching when he catches the ball, he goes right into Bender here. Looks like he might have charged, but I don't know. I think it's a good no call. It was not that much contact. Good act by Bender.
Foul is on Ben Pittman, number 44, who just checked in. So UNC Wilmington has Ryan Rawson, Ben Pittman, Greg Bender, Mark Gary is back in, and Bobby Joe Springer. For Navy, Wojcik, Whitaker, Nate Bailey, number 32, is in. David Robinson and Vernon Butler.
I tell you, I think it's a sign of a good official who won't go for those kind of fakes by the players. You know, defense guys falling down, and all you got to do is not call it two or three times, and it cleans it up. They forget about acting anymore.
I think you're right. Navy leads by 3. 8 minutes remaining in the first half, came a little closer than expected.
Well, maybe, like I say, they need to get fired up here on defense and start playing better. They came out early and showed a little bit of activity, but since then they've just kind of been lulled to sleep by UNCW.
Even though Navy won by 14 their opening round game, Paul Evans was not pleased. Ryan Rawson connects for the Seahawks, who will count out upsetting Navy.
You don't want your team to play and just win. You want them to play, you know, as good as they can. Give 100% all the time. When teams don't play all out, it bothers the coach.
Whitaker from long range. Rawson blocks Robinson off the board. Paul Evans is particularly displeased at the defense in that game.
Well, I can understand why. You know, shots sometimes won't win, but you can always play defense as hard as you possibly can. That's just a hustle. Hustle thing, you know, it didn't take a lot of finesse to be a defensive player.
Rousham has hit his last 5 shots and he has 10 points as UNC Wilmington takes the lead 26-25. And the Seahawk players on their feet applauding their teammates. They're really fired up now. Nate Bailey, number 32, a freshman in there. He had in the starting lineup earlier in the year. Butler puts it up. And he's called for traveling, no basket. Well, the officials seem to be disagreeing. One of them called traveling, the other is called a foul.
Well, as John Bonder is saying, waved the official off. The official over here called traveling. He said, I have a foul first. So what he's saying is that bump that he got there made him travel. And that's...
What is wrong, John?
I think that's good. I mean, if the other official sees it, fine.
Three officials will huddle and discuss the situation. So we've got a timeout with 6:41 remaining in the first half. It's UNC Wilmington 26 and Navy 25.
Meeting the challenge of the mighty Atlantic. Atlantic Marine is coming on strong with 1986 Johnson outboards. And when your boat is powered by an 86 Johnson, the Atlantic belongs to you. Wellcraft, Bayliner, Mako, whatever the boat, whatever the style, Johnson and the professionals from Atlantic Marine make boating fun for you and your family. Climb aboard with Atlantic Marine, your Johnson Outboards dealer in Wrightsville Beach, because the Atlantic is just your size.
We make it happen for you.
I'd like for you to meet Phil Hardy, our service director. Phil's responsible for managing over 50 employees who have won Pontiac Motor Division Service Excellence Award for customer satisfaction for 11 straight years. No other dealership in the Carolinas can claim that.
That's right, Mr. King. I'm proud of my job as service director, and I'm proud of our people. We all know how to be good listeners so we can fix it right the first time.
And that's another reason our customers keep coming back.
It's the Bob King Pontiac Way.
On Ben Pittman of UNC Wilmington, and Navy's possession as play resumes. We have 6:46 remaining in the first half, and the Seahawks of UNC Wilmington pick off another pass. They lead by one with a chance to go up by three.
Bailey tried to force that one into Robinson, but the defense was ready for it.
The Seahawks have hit 8 of their last 9 shots. Brian Rousham has canned 5 in a row.
As you can see, Rousham is not really a center. He'd be a nice big forward for a team that had another big guy, because he's an excellent shooter. He actually plays better facing the basket.
Rousham around David Robinson. Robinson recovers to block the shot.
Boy, that was a nice move by Rousham. Quick move to the basket. This shows you what an athlete David Robinson is to be able to recover.
Kyler Whitaker with a baseline jumper, and he has 10 points.
I tell you, they get more out of that turnout. What I'm saying is, you know, Kyle Whitaker will fill that lane and then go all the way to the other corner. And he gets that shot so many times, it's amazing that the defense just can't adjust to that.
Navy's back on top, 27-26. Whitaker also has 4 assists to go along with 10 points. Bobby Joe Springer. Getting good outside shooting from Sandy Anderson and from Springer. And the Seahawks are back on top with 5:10 remaining in the first half. Butler posting up on Cherry. No foul call as Bender blocked the shot. Butler again. And Russell takes it away from David Robinson.
Well,
look at it. Turn it over. Wojcik up with it. A 2-on-1 against Rousham. And a bad pass by Doug Wojcik. Navy gives it right back.
That's a Brian Rousham is really playing one heck of a game. He's rebounding, he's scoring. Has to play against David Robinson. Just broke up the fast break that time. Would never happen, though. Bobby Joe Springer was lackadaisical, just tried to catch that out of the pass with one hand and almost went out of bounds.
Mark Gary, he's hit 2 long jump shots off the bench. The Seahawks' outside shooting has been outstanding as they open up a 3-point lead. Surprise, surprise. Wojcik short. Robinson tried to deflect it off Mark Gary, but he was out of bounds. It'll be UNC Wilmington's ball. And Cliff Rees, number 44, checks in for the Naval Academy, replacing Kyler Whitaker.
UNCW is a good basketball team. They're 16-12, and if you're going to give them wide open 17, 18 footers, they're going to hit it. Navy's going to have to pick it up. Defensive, their intensity is sad tonight.
Well, I'm sure Paul Evans is in a state of shock right now.
Well, he is not happy.
Rousham hurries the shot and misses it. Vernon Butler with a rebound, clears it out. Nathan Bailey.
Not happy. He's got to be concerned. I don't blame him a bit.
The lob to Robinson. Doug Wojcik connecting with Robinson on a one-hand alley-oop.
Well, that was almost a payback because that could have been in the cylinder. That was a lot closer than one they called earlier on David Robinson. But that sure was a nice pass for Wojcik.
David Robinson has just 6 points. Rousham is free as Robinson went for the steal and didn't get it.
Well, he doesn't have to do that. I mean, he's such a great shot blocker. Even if he lets Rousham catch the ball in there on him, he should go for the steal.
Rousham's hit 6 of 9 shots. He's the leading scorer in the game with 12 points. UNC Wilmington leads by 3. Robinson wants the ball, and he is fouled. Rousham hit him on the arm. Second foul on Brian Rousham. All-conference selections playing in this game, and Robinson and Butler from Navy, and Brian Rousen from UNC Wilmington. Rob Rose of George Mason and John Newman of Richmond also made the first team all-conference squad.
Brian Rousen has definitely got my vote to be on the all-conference team. I tell you, this kid is a competitor, and he's going up against maybe the best big guy in the country.
Well, seems to be some confusion as the officials are stopping play. I think the question is it a one-on-one situation or is it a two-shot foul? He was definitely shooting.
What difference does it make?
Yeah, he made the first.
Either way.
David Robinson in Navy's opening round win over James Madison attempted 22 free throws. He was 14 for 22. So far tonight, he has 7 points, 5 rebounds, and 1 block shot. Butler over the top for the rebound on the miss. Robinson tips it, and Cliff Reeves runs it down the corner.
Well, that's a good break for Navy that time. Butler, boy, he is so strong inside, you just can't keep him from getting those rebounds.
Nathan Bailey on the miss, and there's Rousen blocking Robinson off the boards. Just put a hip into him and kept him right off.
That was really nice. That's something that you like to see the big guys do. He didn't worry about going for it. He just made sure that Robinson didn't have a chance.
2:45 remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington surprisingly leading 32-30. Navy was a big favorite coming into this game.
And they're doing smart here. I think Rousen and Robinson both of them tired from battling each other, so they're going to slow down the pace a little bit here.
Neither Rousen nor Robinson has had a breather in this first half. They both got all the way.
And they're both, you can tell they're both breathing pretty heavily, and they've really been going after it.
Brian Rousen on the turnaround jumper having a big first half with 14 points. We'd like to welcome our ESPN viewers who've joined us. With Mel Proctor along with Bob Talbot from the Patriot Center in Fairfax, Virginia. Semifinal action, the Colonial Athletic Association Tournament. Navy a big favorite against UNC Wilmington, but the Seahawks have the lead 34-30 as Brian Rousen, the all-conference center, has scored 14 first-half points and has thoroughly outplayed Navy's All-American candidate, David Robinson, who has just 7. UNC Wilmington hitting 67% of their field goal attempts so far.
Well, I tell you, a lot of that's due to the lack of intensity Navy showed early in the half. They came out and were very flat defensively. They haven't played like they normally do.
Mark Gary puts it up, and he got fouled by Cliff Reeves, who tipped his elbow. Although David Robinson has scored only 7 points, he and Doug Wojcik combined on a spectacular slam dunk earlier in the first half.
Must be nice to be able to play guard with that guy. Just throw it up anywhere near the basket. He's going to catch it, dunk it in. You can get a lot of assists playing with him.
Mark Gary at the free throw line, a sophomore from Anderson, Indiana. His brother Jeff plays at Vanderbilt. He has a younger brother who's in high school, who's quite a basketball prospect. UNC Wilmington leads Navy 34-30 with a minute and a half remaining in the first half. The winner of this game will meet the winner of our second game tonight between Richmond and George Mason tomorrow night for the conference championship. Substitution for UNC Wilmington, Sandy Anderson, number 22, is back in. For Navy, Kyler Whitaker, number 5, returns.
Hey, we're seeing a little full court pressure here.
This is UNC Wilmington's biggest lead. They're up by 5, 35-30, with 1:25 remaining in the half.
I think right now that Coach Mel Gibson should be thinking about getting Rousen out of there.
There's Rousen with a steal, stepping in front of David Robinson. What a first half he's had.
Don't want him to get him in foul trouble. He's only got 2 right now. Boy, he's playing well.
Sure is.
I think after this offensive time down the court, I'd get him out and make sure that he only has 2 to start this second half.
He scored 14 points. He's blocked out on the boards. Now comes up with a steal. Less than a minute remaining in the first half. UNC Wilmington trying to go up by 7. Rousen over Robinson, who blocks it. Second block shot for David Robinson, who leads the country, averaging 6 rejections per game. 36 seconds remaining. Robinson slips inside. He got pushed.
Yeah, that's what I was afraid of.
Son, Brian Rousen, that'll be his 3rd, and it is.
You don't want that to happen in the class. I know Coach Gibson didn't have a chance to get him out, but Well, you'd like to get him out of there before that happened. And big guys get tired like that. All of a sudden, they start playing with their hands instead of their feet. And that can happen.
Well, Rossum leaves with 14 points and three fouls. He's been replaced by number 55, Don Carey, a 6'8 freshman from Angola, Indiana. David Robinson shooting a 1-1. He's been a double figures in 61 straight games for Naval Academy. He had 32 points, 19 rebounds, and Navy's opening round win over James Madison. The player of the year in the Colonial Athletic Association, his second straight year. He makes one out of two. UNC Wilmington leads 35-31 with 28 seconds remaining in the first half.
I'll tell you what, they sure have played a great first half. All they need here is to run the clock down to about 7 or 8 seconds, start working for the last shot, and they could go in 37-31. That'd really be something.
They've done a great job of protecting the basketball. They turned the ball over only three times to go along with their strong rebounding and good shooting. Springer on the run. Bender keeps it alive. Springer again. And Mel Gibson has to be pleased the way his team performed. They've got an upset on their minds as they lead Navy by four. And Paul Evans is a little disturbed at the way his team has played, particularly on defense in this first half.
Well, he's got to be very concerned. You know, last week we went up and watched Navy play Richmond, and you remember how intense they were, and offensively and defensively. And then the last two games, I was talking to Paul before the game. He was very displeased with their play against Madison. And tonight, they've come out again flat defensively and not have been as intense as they normally are.
We talked about the fact that Navy had beaten UNC Wilmington twice during the regular season and beaten them badly. And would that be a psychological advantage for Navy? I think it, in fact, may have worked in UNC Wilmington's favor. Maybe Navy's taking them too lightly.
Well, obviously, you're right. It's funny. The players just seem to think that, heck, all we got to do is outscore these guys. So, let's just run every time we get the ball, take it down the court. We got such a good offensive team that we'll just score more points than they do. But I tell you, you can't do that.
The comparison between David Robinson of Navy and Brian Rossum of UNC Wilmington. Rossum's outscored Robinson 14-8. David Robinson with a slight edge in rebounding. So it's halftime here at the Patriot Center with our score, UNC Wilmington 35 and Navy 31.
Fall out of the line of everyday cars. Finally, the sale you've been waiting for at Avis. Cut loose with a Cutlass Supreme. Break out in a Buick Skylark. Cast off for a Camaro. Or delight in a Delta 88 Royale Brougham. Climb into a young used car and check out the options. Cruise, AC, AM/FM stereo, and power everything. These cars are covered by Avis's exclusive warranty, and it's easy with on-the-lot financing. Catch a young used car only from Avis and fall out of the pack. New Hanover County Airport.
We at Carolina Savings have always believed that good service is the key to good growth. Today, we have offices throughout southeastern North Carolina, and we're pleased with the way we're growing. Our service is good, and the people of the area enjoy doing business with us. Carolina Savings' objective today is the same as it has always been. We are specialists to our customers in southeastern North Carolina.
At some places that sell computer equipment, equipment is all you get. But Entre Computer Centers give you something extra. People who are with you every step of the way. Entre consultants and software experts who make sure you get what's best for your business. Entre instructors, installers, technicians. At Entre, you get more than leading brands of equipment and software. You get people who help you get the most out of it for as long as you want it.
South 17th Street, Wilmington.
When it comes to fuel oil services, no one can hold a candle to Godwin Oil Company. Don't get burned with a small oil company that can't keep up with your cold weather home heating demands. Godwin Oil Company's large fleet of radio dispatch trucks and vans service home heating systems every hour of the day, even weekends and holidays. And we're located in your hometown. That's why in Wilmington, no one can hold a candle to Godwin Oil Company. Oil heat, the intelligent choice. Call Godwin Oil Company at 762-0312.
Rick Edwards, Pontiac Buick and Leasing, White Bull, announces 9.9% financing on most Pontiacs and Buicks. Pay no money down and lease a Buick Century for only $212.34 per month. We're loaded with Electras and 9.9% financing. We'll lower those monthly payments. Drive the Buick Regal. You'll love that V8 engine. So remember, for 9.9% financing and no money down leasing, see us at Rick Edwards Pontiac Buick and Leasing, downtown Whiteville.
Welcome, Capital Region sports fans. Welcome to Home Team Sports. Unique, unduplicated, enthusiastic, just like you are. And we know what you want. We heard you cheering. Cheering for the home teams at home, right along with the rest of the home team crowds. Because Home Team Sports is the next best thing to cheering at the games. Live, exclusive, regional sports coverage. Events you can't see telecast anywhere else. Over 350 regional events a year. College football and basketball. Tennis. Lacrosse. Thoroughbred racing. Professional boxing. AAA baseball. Home team involvement. Home team excitement. Home team sports. The premium cable channel with only 10 commercial minutes per event. But there's more. A whole lot more. 90 Orioles games, more than 55 home games live from Birdland. 30 Caps games, plus all the home game excitement of the playoffs in the race for the Stanley Cup. Bullets action, all the thunder, all the lightning for 30 games plus home game playoffs. And if you think indoor soccer's a blast, just wait till you see these guys blast the competition. Home Team Sports. Games and events you won't see anywhere else except at the stadium or arena. Winning coverage. An announce team that reads like a who's who in professional sports today. Talented directors and engineering support. Group W know-how. And the power of the signal from the SATCOM 4 satellite working in combination right now to bring you live, state-of-the-art sports entertainment. Home Team Sports. We don't just bring you the action, we make you part of it with live topical call-in shows like Home Team Sports Beat. We keep you informed with highlight shows and interviews with renowned sports personalities. And when all is said and done, the Home Team Sports Wire keeps you up to the minute without missing a beat. Capital Region sports fans, we're not done yet. You see, we're Home Team Sports fans too, and we love showing our team spirit with special promotions and giveaways just to add to the fun. Home Team Sports, cable TV. Excitement you won't find telecast on any other channel. Live, exclusive coverage of over 350 events of significant interest to you, the Home Team fans. And the next best thing to cheering at the game.
The channel you cheer for, Home Team Sports.
Welcome back to the Patriot Center. I've got the head coach of George Mason, the home team, Joe Harrington, here. Joe, what do you think of that first half? Is there an upset in the making?
Could be. I like the way Wilmington is playing. They're in a great offensive tempo. They don't seem to be rushing their offense, and they're getting good shots. And you never know. You'll see what Navy's made out of here the second half.
You know, I said before the game, you know, if you're in UNCW's position, you've got to be loose. They're not favored. Nobody expects them to win, and they seem to come out here and just, you know, they're taking good shots. They shot a tremendous percentage from the floor and are playing well within themselves.
They've been playing well for the last couple of weeks, and like I said, they have been playing well within themselves. They're not rushing it, and Brian Robinson is taking good shots, and they're moving the ball around. They're attacking the right seams on offense, attacking the Navy defense well. They're playing, I think they're playing a very, they played a very sound first half.
Well, you remember last week against you guys, they played a great game right until about, I guess, 5 or 6 minutes ago when your speed and quickness finally just took control of the game.
Well, that's a capacity that we have that maybe Navy doesn't have, and that might be a factor here in the second half.
Well, exactly right. Navy plays that 2-3 zone most of the time, and they're not used to coming full court, and they don't really have the type of speed. So, you know, if they get too far down, they could very easily lose this basketball game.
Well, that's a possibility, but, you know, the big fella's back there, and he's at halftime here with 8 points, and if he's any kind of competitor, you'll see a man turned loose here the second half.
What about your team tonight? Boy, you've been playing real well, and you've got Richmond coming up. You went down 2 weeks ago and beat them by 15 points on their home court. Their only loss, I guess the only two losses they had down at Richmond. What do you think about tonight's game?
Well, our team is playing well right now. We're 9 out of 10 the last 10 games, and the first game against Richmond, we caught them at a great time. Johnny Davis had just, you know, hurt his elbow and he's out for the year, and then Greg Beckler was hobbling with a thigh injury. And we caught them in a little bit of a transition. They're more stable now than they were when we beat them down there a few weeks ago.
Well, but one thing you got for them, you're playing on your home court, and I know your kids are fired up, and you've got the type of team that you've always given Richmond trouble and Navy trouble, so let's hope that continues tonight.
That's about what I told my team this afternoon. You know, we have to take it to those people and really let our athletic talents and basketball skills take over and be very, very aggressive on offense as well as defense.
I tell you, I've really been impressed with Kenny Sanders. He has played tremendously for you, and he seems to get better every game, and he's only a freshman.
Bob, you know, riding over there, I was thinking about Kenny. He really has been remarkable when you think about it. He hasn't played competitively for 2 years, and he steps in as halfway through the year, and he's been very consistent, not only in scoring, but he's been an excellent rebounder. He's passed well. His defense has improved. I've been really impressed with his game.
We have, too, and Rob Rose has played his usual consistent game for you, and Ricky Wilson seems to really have picked up the pace the last 10 or 15 games here.
They're playing like well-seasoned veterans, and, you know, they want to go out and reach our goal. I guess it's every team's goal to play in NCAA playoffs, and they've been playing like we may get there, but it's still a long way to go. Two big nights.
Well, you're 18-10, another great year. Do you feel you have to win the tournament here to get a postseason bid?
Well, I think so. With the records that Navy and Richmond have right now, they've had a tremendous regular season, you know, record, and I think we're going to have to win tonight to make some noise, and it's within our grasp, but it's going to be a ball game, and we're still 40 minutes away from that.
Well, listen, thanks a lot for coming on with us. Good luck later tonight. We'll be right back after this message.
We make it happen for you.
I'd like for you to meet Phil Hardy, our service director. Phil's responsible for managing over 50 employees who have won Pontiac Motor Division Service Excellence Award for customer satisfaction for 11 straight years. No other dealership in the Carolinas can claim that.
That's right, Mr. King. I'm proud of my job as service director, and I'm proud of our people. We all know how to be good listeners so we can fix it right the first time.
And that's another reason our customers keep coming back.
It's the Bob King Pontiac Way.
Atlantic Marine, coming on strong for your boating pleasure. Your Mercury Outboards dealer. Whatever your boating needs, the professionals from Atlantic Marine make boating fun. Mercury Outboards, Wellcraft, Bayliner, and Mako boats. Parts and accessories to keep your boat in the water and complete dry storage when it's not. Join the fun. Make the most of the Atlantic with Atlantic Marine, your Mercury Outboards dealer in Wrightsville Beach. And propel into excitement.
Excuse me, have you opened your IRA?
I've already got a pension plan.
But will it be enough? A People's Federal IRA gives you a tax break, too.
IRA? I'm a little short of cash right now.
You can start a People's Federal IRA for just $25.
IRA? Who has time for all the paperwork?
Opening a People's Federal IRA is as easy as filling out that scorecard.
Where do I sign?
Nice score. For a tax break now and a small fortune later, start a People's Federal IRA. There's no excuse not to.
To be effective in business, you can do without a lot of frills, except one. You can't get by without a telephone. So when you need to hit the road, take it with you. But you'd better make sure it's a car telephone from Communication Specialists. You'll have one of the best business phones in the world traveling with you from the company that has served southeastern North Carolina for over 30 years. Take it from George Kennedy. Call Communication Specialists and ask them what they can do for you.
One call from you sets Domino's Pizza in motion.
One call does it all, that's fast.
From that moment on, we do everything to make sure your hot, delicious, custom-made pizza is delivered to your door in less than 30 minutes.
Does it all.
Domino's Pizza delivers.
Great taste, like where you want it to be. Domino's.
first half for UNC Wilmington was Brian Rossman here. Bobby Joe Springer hits him. He had 14 points the first half and hit 7 of 11 shots.
Well, David Robson there made a mistake and tried to go for the steal and left Brian Rossman wide open. Nobody else can guard him. Here we go with Owochik and making that nice lob pass to Robson. That big left hand goes up there about a foot and a half above the rim and just drops it home.
David Robinson, though, Bob, took only 4 shots in the first half. He's got to be more involved in the offense if Navy hopes to win this game.
Well, that's very unusual for Robinson only to have 4 shots at this time of the game, but I think you have to give credit to Wilmington, UNC Wilmington, because they're keeping the ball away from him. And Navy's the kind of team that they're not really being very patient tonight and spending a lot of time.
Look at the shooting percentage by UNC Wilmington. 59%, that's remarkable because Navy is 3rd in the nation in field goal percentage defense. They've allowed the opposition an average shooting percentage on the year of only 41%, and their last 7 games only 40%. Yet UNC Wilmington is shooting 59%, led by Brian Rossum with 14 points.
Well, the problem is that the intensity, the defensive intensity, has just not been there for Navy. This is not the way Navy normally plays defense. And the Seahawks are taking advantage of it.
Kyler Whitaker with 10 points. David Robinson has 8. But as we mentioned, he took only 4 shots, made 3 of them in the first half. Vernon Butler, whom they depend on so heavily, was 2 for 8 from the floor. By the way, we said that Brian Rossum picked up a 3rd foul. That foul was charged to Bobby Joe Springer. And Paul Evans, Navy's coach, was very upset because he thought that Rossum committed the 3rd foul, which would make for a completely different situation. Mel Gibson would have to bench if he picks up a 4th, but now he has only 2.
Well, that was a break because, as we saw on the screen, he definitely fouled David Robinson as he was coming across the floor, but the official said that Bobby Joe Springer also fouled, so that bailed Brian Rossum out.
UNC Wilmington has never beaten Navy. They are 0-4 against the Naval Academy, and the Seahawks will open with Sandy Anderson and Bobby Joe Springer in the backcourt, Greg Bender, Brian Rossum, and Charles Cherry on the front line, the same way they started the game. Navy goes to Doug Wojcik and Kyler Whitaker, David Robinson, Vernon Butler, and Carl Liebert, same way they opened this game.
They made a change, though, and they've got Robinson playing in the middle of the zone instead of out on the wing.
It's like a 2-1-2 zone.
Well, they normally have Robinson out on the wing and Butler in the middle, but they've switched. And that's because Rousland's been getting that ball in the high post and having a lot of shots there, so they feel, I'm sure, Coach Evans says, we'll put Robinson up there and make a lot harder on Rousland.
Ball is tipped away, but Sandy Anderson is up with it. Charles Cherry crashing the boards.
Well, look at the ball. He can't get a hold of it. There it is. Robinson's a little disgusted with the officiating. Felt like he got fouled.
UNC Wilmington with a 4-point lead. 1 minute into the second half. They go right into Robinson, and he gets fouled. Signed Brian Rossum, and that's number 3.
Well, that is 3, so that would have been rough, but that would have been number 4. Rossum that time made a defense mistake. He let Robinson get in front of him real low, and then Robinson leaned on him and wouldn't allow Rossum to front him. So there's nothing you can do when Robinson gets the ball in that close to the basket.
David Robinson scored 638 points coming into this tournament, marking the second time he's topped the 600-point mark in his career, the only Navy player ever to accomplish that feat. He's now 3rd on the all-time scoring list behind Vernon Butler, who's number 1, and Kevin Sinnott, who played from 75 through 79. He is 2nd, but Robinson should pass both of them next year.
Yeah, once he stays uninjured, there's no question that he'll set a new scoring mark and a new rebounding mark for Navy.
35-32, UNC Wilmington leading.
And you know Navy's going to come out here this second half. They're going to play a lot more inspired basketball, especially defensively. And they're going to make UNC earn everything they get.
Greg Bender on the miss and a good block out by Carl Liebert, keeping Cherry off the boards. Here's Doug Wojcik, cross court to Whitaker, into Robinson.
Yeah.
They're pounding it inside to the big man to turn this game around.
You don't think that Coach Evans had anything to say about Jay Robson only getting 4 shots, did you, at halftime?
For those who watched Paul Evans and his team go to the locker room, they said he stayed outside for about 5 minutes, pacing the hallway with steam coming out of his
his ears before he went in. Talk to his club.
Yeah, he's probably just trying to cool down and didn't want to really scream at his players, but wanted to make sure that he got his point across. Looks like he did.
Springer,
good lower body shot.
Robinson with a rebound, really beginning to take charge in the second half. Whitaker goes inside to Butler. Good head fake.
Look at that one. I don't know how in the world he got that ball off and in into the basket.
He is awfully strong. And UNC Wilmington will take a timeout. As Navy has come out with a flurry to take the lead, 36-35, with 17:37 remaining in the second half. Let's eavesdrop on UNC Wilmington coach Mel Gibson.
That puts us in a bind. Keep penetrating now. Greg Bender, listen to me. Their guards are cheating so bad. He's coming up here, and Greg is step in there.
At Cape Fear Ford Peugeot, we really mean it when we say we'll get together, just give us a try. Come in and choose a new Ford car or truck, a Peugeot sports sedan, or one of Wilmington's finest selection of quality used cars. Our experienced sales staff will fit your needs with what you want to pay and then negotiate a price that pleases you. We call it getting together at Cape Fear Ford Peugeot, and it has kept our customers coming back to trade with us for 49 years.
When Domino's Pizza delivers, people come to their senses. A scent teaser, a family pleaser.
And one call does it all.
And it's 37-35 Navy. They've outscored UNC Wilmington 6-0 to open the second half.
UNC Dev has yet to score, so they need to get something on the board here.
And the ball was kicked by Vernon Butler, so a new 45-second count for UNC Wilmington.
That defensive move that Coach Evans made by putting David Robson in the middle of the zone instead of on the wing seems to be paying dividends right now. They can't get it into Brian Rousen.
They've taken away that turnaround jump shot that Rousen was scoring with so effectively in the first half.
Sure has.
Sandy Anderson tries to penetrate.
You can just see the whole Navy team. The intensity defensively is just so much different. Look at them. They're ball hawking the ball. Now they're trying to make steals. And sure makes a lot of difference to Wilmington because they're not getting those easy shots so easy.
That must have been some halftime speech by Paul Evans. They want to go into Rousen, but they're having trouble. There they get it to him, and Robinson gets a piece of the shot. Charles Cherry on the follow.
Boy, really hit the board well that time.
Second basket of the game for Cherry.
That's unusual against Navy. You don't see too many teams get offensive rebound with Robinson and Butler in there.
Paul Evans' team has an 11-game win streak on the line. Doug Wojcik shooting properly tonight. He took 6 shots the first half, which is an awfully high number for him.
Well, with shots like that, he barely hit the rim from only 15 feet. He didn't look real confident that time.
They go into Rousen. Posting up on Robinson, he made him change the shot. But Rousen gets in, grabs a rebound, shoots an air ball. And he's got a pushing foul on Vernon Butler, I believe.
He must be tough to play inside. And
no, it's on Carl Lieberger. That's his third.
You get the ball inside and you turn around, and there's David Robinson staring you in the face. Sure makes you change the shot. Rousen that time had the really archy shot, and there's no chance for it going in.
Minutes remaining in the second half. They're tied 37-all. UNC Wilmington led 35-31 at the half. Butler tips it out of bounds.
Defense has really changed the game. Navy's come out the second half very aggressive. And UNCW is having a hard time penetrating that zone now.
24 seconds remain on the 45-second shot clock for UNC Wilmington.
Springer penetrates. Misses the pull-up jumper. Cherry bats it into the air.
Boy, Cherry.
Great play.
Good is playing hard. Come up with a couple of real tough rebounds this half. Look how far out the Navy guards are this half. First half, UNCW is just dribbling the ball anywhere they want it. Now they can't even get a pass.
They've also taken away UNC Wilmington's outside shooting. Cherry misses the baseline jumper, but he gets inside again. Feeds Rousham. It counts. Oh. David Robinson commits the foul.
That was some move by Brian Rousham inside. Great, beautiful pump fake. Got Robinson in the air. Offense rebound is third of the half. Nice shovel pass. What's this pump fake?
Ryan Rousham has 16 points, 8 rebounds. He goes to the free throw line. We get a substitution for Navy. Number 24, Derek Turner, checks in, a freshman from Burke, Virginia. He was the most valuable player at the Navy prep school last year, where he averaged 20 points a game, and he relieves Carl Liebert, who has 3 fouls.
We're bringing Turner in to get some defensive rebounding help. Cherry has just gone wild down there this half, getting 3 offensive rebounds.
17 points for Brian Rousham, and UNC Wilmington leads by 3, 40-37, regaining their composure after Navy reeled off 6 great points to open the second half. Tyler Whitaker. Whitaker has 12 points, and Navy cuts the lead to 1.
You know, Whitaker impresses me more and more as I see. You normally don't see him take the ball, put it on the floor, and go to the basket like he did that time, but you know, he can do that. He's an excellent jump shooter anytime.
Whitaker, a senior, closing out a fine career at Navy. He's from Lebanon, Oregon. Greg Bender, just beginning his collegiate career as a freshman, and he nails one. He has 5 points, and it's 42-39, UNC Wilmington. 14-39 remaining in the game. David Robinson has a lot of company inside, doesn't he?
Yeah, wherever he goes, he draws the crowd. Especially on the basketball court.
Get it into the big man using his muscle, and that foul may be on Russell.
Yeah, he called that on Bender.
Or on Springer.
On Springer, okay. One of the guys outside.
Two fouls on Bobby Joe Springer. And Mel Gibson is going to make a change. They'll bring Mark Gary off the bench. Gary played in the first half and provided some outside shooting, getting a couple of long jump shots, kind of loosen up that zone defense. He replaces Bender. David Robinson, who in his career at Navy has scored over 30 points 13 times. He had 37 earlier this year against Delaware. That's a career high. He has 12 so far in this game.
They're starting to go to him more now, and you know, that's all it takes. You get the ball to him, he's going to either get fouled or scored every time.
Still struggling with his free throw shooting. UNC Wilmington leads 42-40. Three guard offense being employed again by UNC Wilmington. It worked effectively for them in the first half. Rousham on the half hook. Robinson with a rebound. He has 9 rebounds this evening.
That was a nice move that time to Rousham. He got a little baby hook.
Derek Turner going to the basket.
Boy. He sure went hard to the basket that time. Put up his left-hander.
Paul Evans said any other year, Derek Turner might be a starter, but we're so deep this year that he doesn't get to play that much. That's how far the Navy basketball program has come in the last 5 years. They've won 20 or more games each of the last 3 seasons. No other service academy has even posted back-to-back 20-win seasons.
You know, Paul Evans has put together some kind of program there, no question about it. And he was doing well over there even before Robinson showed up, but that sure has helped him.
It also helped that Robinson drew 4 inches, too. Rousham over to Robinson. What a shot. David Robinson has picked up his 3rd foul.
I tell you, old Brian Rousham has come to play tonight. That first game down there, these 2 teams met, and he only shot 3 for 18. He's made up for it in the last 2 games because he had 20 points and 12 rebounds over at Navy. And tonight, he has really played well.
Rob Wagner, number 12, a junior from Muncie, Indiana, checks in at guard, replacing Mark Gary for UNC Wilmington. Brian Rossum has 19 points, 9 rebounds. Now to put his team up by 3 points. And an even 20 for Rossum. They've got a timeout on the floor with 13:03 remaining in the second half. It's UNC Wilmington 45 and Navy 42.
We make it happen.
I'd like for you to meet Phil Hardy, our service director. Phil's responsible for managing over 50 employees who have won Pontiac Motor Division Service Excellence Award for customer satisfaction for 11 straight years. No other dealership in the Carolinas can claim that.
That's right, Mr. King. I'm proud of my job as service director, and I'm proud of our people. We all know how to be good listeners so we can fix it right the first time.
And that's another reason our customers keep coming back.
It's the Bob King Pontiac Way.
Let Avis make your move an easy one. Rent a truck from Avis. Avis trucks are fully equipped to make your move easier. Like these trucks which feature hydraulic lifts for those heavy items. Avis has trucks with moving capabilities of up to 7 tons, as well as vans, high cube trucks, and only Avis offers flatbeds too. Avis is open from 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. for your convenience. And with attractive rates and excellent commercial rates for companies, Avis is the place to come to when you need to rent a truck. Avis Rentals, New Hanover County Airport.
Tomorrow night, you'll see the championship game of this Colonial Athletic Association tournament live at 8 o'clock in the Patriot Center. I think most folks thought that it would be Navy against the winner of our second game, Richmond against George Mason. But right now, UNC Wilmington leads by 3. There are the Richmond Spiders waiting to play tonight's second game against George Mason. This has been a real surprise so far.
It's been a tremendous game, and Navy came out a little bit flat that first half.
They go into Robinson over Rousham. Robinson again on the slam, and he got fouled. And it's on Rousham, and he's really hot because it looked like Charles Cherry actually committed the foul.
Sure did.
4 fouls now on Rousham.
Let's see if we can see it here. Robinson, well, they call him using the body, I guess, but boy, that sure was a kick and foul. I don't really think he gained any advantage then.
If anybody committed the foul, it was Cherry.
It sure was.
David Robinson's hit 5 of 9 free throw attempts. He ties it at 45, and Brian Rossum is in deep foul trouble with 4 with 12:45 remaining in the game.
Well, boy, that is a costly, could be a real costly foul. He has been their mainstay tonight. He's had 2 three-point plays in the last 2 minutes and just played super tonight.
Wojcik trying to steal the ball from Rob Wagner. Butler slaps it away. And Tyler Whitaker's up with it as Navy has a chance to take the lead. You think they'd go right inside and try to get Rousham to pick up that 5th foul. And they do, right to Robinson, but Rousham slaps it away.
Well, neither team, both teams made bad passes those last 2 times down the court. Trying to force the ball inside. Just got to have a little patience.
12 minutes remaining in the game. Inside. What a game he's having with 22 points.
You know, again, David Robinson that time tries to go for a steal, and I don't know why. The way he can block shots, he just got to stay in there and make Rousham shoot over him.
He's also liable to pick up his 4th foul if he's not careful. Whitaker on the miss. Robinson with authority.
Well, that was an emphatic dunk. No question about that. Wow.
So the 2 big men having a shootout. David Robinson has 17 points. Brian Rossum of UNC Wilmington has 22. Robinson's hit 6 of 8 shots from the floor. We're tied at 47. Whitaker misses the steal. Anderson penetrates. Good recovery by Navy. Charles Cherry has his shot blocked by Derek Turner. Wojcik pushing it up court. UNC Wilmington hustled back defensively.
Yeah, they played super tonight. You got to give Milt Gibson, his coach, that credit. They are very, very well prepared. Kids are loose, and they're just playing about as well as they can play.
They're giving Wojcik the outside shot. Look at him sag off of it. Butler inside. Muscles in another one.
Well, Rousham's in trouble. There's nothing he can do now with 4 fouls.
And UNC Wilmington will call a timeout. So is they've got a timeout on the floor with 10:37 remaining in the second half with the score Navy 49 and the University of North Carolina Wilmington 47.
Many changes have taken place at Carolina Savings and Loan since it was formed in 1912. But home loans and savings accounts have always been our specialty, and they still are. In recent years, however, checking accounts, 24-hour teller machines, and consumer loans have been added to our services. And looking to the future, Carolina Savings and Loan will continue to provide the services that our customers need. Carolina Savings, serving southeastern North Carolina.
Welcome to Wells Oldsmobile in Whiteville. There's excitement in the air because we have one of the largest selection of Oldsmobiles, GMC trucks, and Jeeps in our history. Now is the time to start planning your vacation while you can choose from our big stock of Oldsmobiles, GMC pickups, safari vans, and customized vans. Also, the versatile lineup of Jeep wagons, CJ7s, and the four-wheeler of the year, our all-new Jeep Comanche. We take pride in helping you select the new car of your choice at Wells Oldsmobile, right in the heart of Whiteville.
Mel Proctor with Bob Talbot at the Patriot Center in Fairfax, Virginia, with 10:37 remaining in the game. Navy leads UNC Wilmington 49-47, but this has been a dogfight.
Well, it sure has. Been a great game. They've got Rassam out there now. They're going to rest him a little while on the bench. It's going to be very important if they can stay in the game with him on the bench.
Robinson with a steal, the lead pass to Wojcik, and what a play by Bobby Joe Springer.
Great hustle there. You saw that play. Soon as Rassam went out of the game, Coach Evans moved David Robinson back to the wing and Butler back to the middle on his 2-3 zone.
Ben Pittman, number 44, has replaced Brian Rassam for UNC Wilmington.
This is a real important stretch right here for UNC Wilmington. About their leading scorer and best player, see if they can stay in the game.
Tyler Whitaker off the mark. Butler hammering the board, but Springer has it. So quick. Such a great ball handler. And he takes it himself. And it's basket interference called on Pittman, but I'd love to see a replay of this because it looked like the ball was well off the rim.
I think that was a good call, Mel. I really do. Let's see here. But it looked like the ball was going out, and it's still on the rim there when...
I don't know.
It's hard to tell from there. Let's see if we can see another angle here.
Looked to me like it had rolled off.
Well, I think it was still had contact. That was too close for comfort. It's a shame because Pittman made a great play.
Ball stripped away from David Robinson, and Sandy Anderson is up with it. Navy leads 49-47. So the Middies were unable to capitalize. And UNC Wilmington has a chance to tie it.
They can just stay in this thing until they get Brian Rousen back.
Anderson from the outside.
Whoa. Great shot. Boy, that's a long one out there. One of those 23-footers. Might be a three-pointer.
Sandy Anderson has 7 points. He's a transfer from Belmont Abbey, which is where Al McGuire began his collegiate coaching career before he went to Marquette. Derek Turner tries to turn in, and it's slapped out of bounds. Meets the winner of tonight's second game between Richmond and George Mason. You'll see that one coming up on Home Team Sports.
Get off of 44. Everybody go.
Navy's 11-game win streak on the line. Ball slapped away by Pittman. Robinson. And let's see whose ball it is. It belongs to Navy.
John Bonder saying, out of bounds to Navy. Made no bones about it. That's a good way to call him like that. Bonner is a good official. He's been around a long time.
Whitaker into Butler on a post-up. Looked like he might have been fouled.
Well, he took a bad shot off bounce. You know, just in hopes of the foul. You can't do that. You got to have a good shot.
We're tied 49-all, 8.5 remaining.
Navy's not taking advantage of Brian Rousen's absence, and they may pay for it down the line.
At what point will Mel Gibson bring him back in?
I'd say maybe six or 5 minutes to go.
Robinson on the rebound. We've got a foul.
That's all right.
It's on Greg Bender, his first. That's the 15th foul on UNC Wilmington. Number 44, Cliff Rees, a sophomore from Ellicott City, checks in for Navy. So they've got Whitaker, Derek Turner, Rees, Robinson, and Butler in the game.
Taking what you get.
It's a big lineup.
It sure is a big lineup. It's a better shooting lineup. They're going to play Whitaker out here on the point. And of course, Wilmington is countering with a 1-3-1 zone, and they're going to play Whitaker. They're not going to play him the same way they do Wojcik.
Robinson being banged around inside by Ben Pittman. I think David's getting a little upset. Pittman's really putting the body on it.
Pittman's playing well. He's doing exactly what he's been told. He's hustling, trying to front David Robinson.
Six on the shot clock. Right there. And a foul is called on Pittman for banging Robinson. Third foul on Ben.
It's almost like the NBA. You know, you can call that foul anytime you want to. I guess you just let them play until you finally they're going to call Pittman with the hold. I mean, that's it's been happening on both ends of the court for both these teams. Right?
Whitaker is open. Shoots a brick, but gets it back. Tries to go into Robinson. It's deflected. They finally get it.
What hands? What hands? Well, Turner threw that ball so hard, it almost it would have hit the backboard. It would have cracked it, but somehow.
Robinson was wearing a catcher's mitt.
I tell you.
And Navy leads 51-49 with 7:14 remaining. Been a good game.
Okay, there's nothing like college basketball, especially this time of year.
Sandy Anderson in traffic, and he got fouled by Derek Turner.
He's going to put Rousen back in with 7 minutes to go. And you know they haven't. I think they've lost any points since he's been out.
No, they really did an excellent job of treading water with Rousen on the bench with four fouls, and now he's back in. Sandy Anderson will shoot two free throws. He was fouled with the active shooting. Junior from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. 66% free throw shooter. He's made just one of three tonight. Doug Wojcik replaces Derek Turner for Navy.
That was a kind of a peculiar lineup that Paul Evans had at that time. He had a 6'4 guard and a 6'6 guard. Neither one of them great ball handlers. Very big team.
UNC Wilmington has now made 6 of 9 free throw attempts. Navy is 7 for 12. It's a 1-point ball game. 51-50 Navy, 6:59 remaining. And UNC Wilmington again sagging back in that zone with Wojcik in there. Robinson.
That's where they wanted that time.
Butler on the follow. Let him down. Let the Butler do it.
That's the problem, yeah. It was Vernon. They did a good job in defensing Robinson, but Vernon Butler was right there for the rebound, something he's done all his career.
Navy leads by 3. 6.5 remaining. Rousen. Rousen has 22 to lead UNC Wilmington. David Robinson has 19 to top the Navy score. Got Rousen and Pittman in there at the same time. Rousen, the Robinson slaps it away, but he was out of bounds. So it'll be UNC Wilmington's ball.
I don't even know how smart that is for Robinson. I mean, try for those steals, because if he doesn't get them, it leaves Rousen a wide open path to the basket.
And we've got a timeout at the 6:10 mark in the second half with a score. Navy 53 and UNC Wilmington 50.
Atlantic Marine, coming on strong for your boating pleasure. Your Mercury Outboards dealer. Whatever your boating needs, the professionals from Atlantic Marine make boating fun. Mercury Outboards, Wellcraft, Bayliner, and Mako boats. Parts and accessories to keep your boat in the water and complete dry storage when it's not. Join the fun. Make the most of the Atlantic with Atlantic Marine, your Mercury Outboards dealer in Wrightsville Beach. And propel into excitement.
This is Don Kimball. It's that exciting time of year again. Basketball fever grips the Carolinas. And at Don Kimball Chevrolet, we've got even more excitement. 7.9% financing on Chevettes. Economical and sporty. 9.9% financing on most new 86 Chevrolet cars and trucks. Save hundreds now with this special financing. Remember, Don Kimball Chevrolet, 228 South College Road. The good people can save you money.
The spring on Home Team Sports, Caps home playoff games, Bullets home playoff games, and selected Blast playoff games, all live and exclusive, coming your way on Home Team Sports, a channel you cheer for this spring. And we're bringing you tonight college basketball action, semifinals of the Colonial Athletic Association tournament here in Fairfax, Virginia. It's been a tight one all the way. Navy leads UNC Wilmington by three. Navy a big favorite coming into the game. Top seeded in the tournament, winners of 11 straight. Bender may have gotten fouled by Tyler Whitaker. Looked like he hit him on an arm.
He definitely got a piece of the ball.
Navy with a chance to go up by five. They're giving Wojcik the outside shot, but he's not taking it as he was in the first half. They go into Robinson over three men.
Unbelievable shot that time. Reverse pivot while he was in the air. He reversed himself, shot, didn't use the backboard, but that soft shot again. Ball stayed in.
At the other end, Rousham comes up short. Robinson with a rebound. Navy with a chance to go up by seven. Butler wants the ball, and Whitaker tries to deliver it, but Sandy Anderson knocks it out of bounds.
Look at this play. He has really surrounded David Robinson.
We've got a timeout on the floor with 5:23 remaining in the game. It's Navy 55, UNC Wilmington 50.
When it comes to fuel oil services, no one can hold a candle to Godwin Oil Company. Don't get burned with a small oil company that can't keep up with your cold weather home heating demands. Godwin Oil Company's large fleet of radio dispatch trucks and vans service home heating systems every hour of the day, even weekends and holidays. And we're located in your hometown. That's why in Wilmington, no one can hold a candle to Godwin Oil Company. Oil heat, the intelligent choice. Call Godwin Oil Company at 762-0312.
Fall out of the line of everyday cars. Finally, the sale you've been waiting for at Avis. Cut loose with a Cutlass Supreme. Break out in a Buick Skylark. Cast off for a Camaro. Or delight in a Delta 88 Royale Brougham. Climb into a young used car and check out the options. Cruise, AC, AM/FM stereo, and power everything. These cars are covered by Avis's exclusive warranty, and it's easy with on-the-lot financing. Catch a young used car only from Avis and fall out of the pack. New Hanover County Airport.
In our two centers, Brian Rousham of UNC Wilmington with 22 points, 9 rebounds, but David Robinson coming to life in the second half. He now has 21 points and 13 boards. And he has 13 of Navy's 24 second-half points.
Well, I think most of that's not due to Robinson. It's just due to the other Navy players getting the ball to him.
A reach-in foul on Bobby Joe Springer, fouling Vernon Butler.
You know, sometimes when things are, you know, not in the heat of the battle, or Navy's not worried, the other players forget about Robinson. They start taking the offense on themselves. But when it gets down to the nitty-gritty, you see where Navy goes with the ball. What you said earlier about Robinson, I don't think there's any question. He is definitely the best defensive center and the best rebounding center in the game today. Offensively, he has a lot to, you know, to go, a long way to go with his offensive repertoire, but I tell you, he can learn that.
He's only a junior.
Yeah. The jumping ability, the athleticism, that's something that he's got, and, you know, you can't take that away from him.
Vernon Butler makes one out of two, and Navy leads by six, 56-50, but it's been a struggle for the Middies tonight. Minutes remaining in the game. Rousham wants the ball, but the Seahawks are having a tough time getting it to him. See him look into him, but they just can't get it there.
Well,
now he moves outside. Bender from the top of the key.
Maybe he's playing a triangle and two.
And following his miss and puts it in.
Took a little time for UNCW to figure out what they were doing, but Whitaker and the two big guys were playing a 1-2 zone with Reese and Wojcik playing man-to-man.
UNC Wilmington is sagging off both Reese and Wojcik, giving them the outside shot. They go into Robinson in a crowd, and he muscles it up, tips it up, still can't put it in, and Butler does it.
Well, Rassen did a tremendous job that time on Robinson, but Cherry did not block out big Vernon Butler inside. That's two offensive rebounds he's had this lately. Put him back in.
Navy leads 58-52, 3:50 remaining in the game.
And you can see these, look, they got the guards. See, they're playing man-to-man on the guards, and the three big guys are just playing the zone inside.
And it's off Brian Rousham out of bounds as UNC Wilmington commits a costly turnover.
I think Coach Gibson needs a timeout. There's the offensive rebound. Navy's doubled UNCW on the offensive boards, and Vernon Butler's really hurt him inside the last couple times.
Cliff Reese, that was a pass intended for Butler, but he thought it was
for Robinson, and he just let it go.
And Butler and Reese trying to get things straightened out.
Let's see if they stay in this Divas nest.
Yep, it's starting to give 3:18 left in the game.
It's giving them a lot of trouble.
Rousham blocked by Robinson. That's his third block shot. Look at the big man handle it. Feeds Butler beautifully.
What about that?
6'11 point guard.
Yes, sir. And you see him evade the charge at the other end, made the pass, and didn't run over Bobby Joe Springer, which a lot of guards will even do.
Navy is breathing a little easier. They open up an 8-point lead. This ties their biggest lead. 2:50 left in the game. Sandy Anderson changes his mind, feeds Cherry. Robinson blocks it, but he'll be called for a foul. That's number 4 on David Robinson.
Thank you, Bob. Which way you want to get?
Watch David Robinson in action as he blocks a shot, comes up with a ball, and makes like a point guard.
Look at it go straight up, blocks it, doesn't knock it out of bounds. Now he has no one to throw it to. He said, well, I just might as well leave the fast break through. See there how he evades the charge on Bobby Joe's trying to draw it on him. Yeah, the kid's amazing. There's no question about it.
Incredible agility for a guy 6'11".
Yeah, he sure is.
Charles Cherry has 5 points. He averages a shade over 7 per game. A junior from Fayetteville, North Carolina. 2 big free throws for UNC Wilmington. Mark Gary, number 15, checks in for the Seahawks. The Navy leads by 6 with 2:44 remaining. Full court pressure now by UNC Wilmington. Double team threes and force a turnover. Gary will take it, and he got fouled by Vernon Butler. He could have passed ahead of him to Bobby Joe Springer, who was wide open.
Well, I think he didn't have any idea that Butler was going to be closing that fast. See, he just takes his time, goes in there real nice, but, well, you can't do that. You've got to get that ball in there. He should have passed it ahead to Bobby Joe, who had the wide-open layup. Much better really hustle and get down here and save these 2 points.
That's the first foul on Vernon Butler. Mark Gary at the free throw line. He is 1 for 2 on the night.
Well, it paid off. That's the kind of hustle that's made Vernon Butler the great player he is. He just never says die and went on in, and that saved 2 points, or 1 point for sure, and maybe 2.
Gary makes 1 out of 2, and it's 60-55 Navy, but time running out on UNC Wilmington. 2:30 left. There's a big steal by Charles Cherry, feeding Gary. Here come the Seahawks.
And they got to get the ball to Wojcik. I don't know what they're doing with these other guys bringing the ball up the court. Give the ball to Wojcik, clear out his way.
Gary tried to draw a charge, but nothing was called. Butler finds Rees open underneath, and he got fouled by Grant.
I'll tell you what.
They call this on Rousham? No, it's on Butler.
They were really fortunate that time. Navy, I'm saying. Whitaker is down there, and Reese dribbling the ball. I have no idea. They've got Doug Wojcik, who is probably the size for Greg Beckwith, the best ball hitter in the conference. Get him the ball, let him earn his money. That's what they pay him for. They don't pay him, but that's what he's in there for. Look at that. Got to be a foul there on somebody.
Nothing was called.
Incidental contact.
Cliff Reese converts the first free throw. That's his first point of the game. He's an excellent free throw shooter, 86% on the season. He was a starter at the off-guard spot most of last year for Navy. Cherry really banging the board.
Yeah, he has played a heck of a game inside. He's only 6'4", but playing like he's about 6'9 or 6'10 tonight.
Navy leads by 4, 61-57, a minute 58 left in regulation. Bobby Joe Springer on the scoop. Robinson almost tipped it in. Rousham nails it.
I think Jerry's the one that kept it alive. He was up there just as high as David Robinson.
2-point ball game at 61-59 Navy.
They ought to get the ball to Wojcik. Whitaker is a nice player. He's a heavy shooter, but he's not a ball. He's 6'7". He's too slow to be handling the ball out here against this type of pressure.
Whitaker is open. Butler on the tip end.
He's going to fall off.
He went over somebody's back. The basket does not count. There's a foul on Vernon Butler.
I saw it coming. He did push off. Let's see.
Second foul on Butler. Navy's over the limit, so a couple of free throws coming up for UNC Wilmington with a chance to tie it.
Let's see if we see this push off. What's Cherry? It was hard to see. We didn't have the right proper angle at that time. It's a tremendous tip-in, left-handed tip-in, but before he went up and tipped that one in.
Charles Cherry is a 73% free throw shooter. He's 2-for-2 at the line tonight, and he has a chance to tie it, shooting a 1-and-1. Navy. A minute 26 remaining, and Cherry can tie it up. Just a short while ago, Navy had an 8-point lead. This has been quite a comeback.
Yeah, I'll tell you that. Charles Cherry has played one half of the game now. I tell you, he has got some rebounds and hit the boards.
Cherry makes one out of two, and Navy clings to a 1-point lead, 61-60. And again, we welcome our ESPN viewers, Mel Proctor along with Bob Talent. Here at the Patriot Center with a minute 16 remaining. Navy's 11-game win streak is on the line. The Middies ranked 19th by Associated Press, 12th by the Sporting News. And they've had all they can handle from UNC Wilmington tonight.
They sure have. UNC Wilmington has played the perfect game tonight. Their coaching plan was absolutely perfect against Navy, and they executed it.
There are 50 seconds left in the game, and only 10 seconds left on the 45-second clock. They better look for a shot, and they turn it over. But it was deflected by one of the Seahawks. It's off the hand of Mark Gary, and Navy will get the ball back.
He knows it. It hit his hand. Just a bad break. He was just trying to come back and cover up, and it actually hit his hand, went out of bounds. Good call by the official.
So Navy gets a break on the deflection by Gary, and the Middies will have the ball when play resumes. See what happened.
Let's see if it just hits his hands.
Yep.
There it is.
See the ball change.
Yep.
Rotation. He touched it.
He knows a good call.
See the official grab his shirt.
Well, he just wanted to make sure that he got it. That was a good call.
Well, if it comes down to this game being decided at the free throw line here, the shooting percentage is for Navy. Cliff Reeves, the best of the bunch. Whitaker and Wojcik above 70%. I would say foul David Robinson because he's very inconsistent.
Okay, listen, they got five on the shot clock. Look for this one.
Back it back.
Listen, look for him to duck in hard. Butler ducking in. Robinson curling out the lob because they only have 5 seconds.
Back and give us some
saying, look out for the lob because Navy has only 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Right.
44 seconds left in the game. And this has been quite an evening so far.
Sure has.
Paul Evans chewing his fingernails. There's the time remaining on the shot clock. 5 seconds left. Navy will inbound the baseline. Kyler Whitaker will throw it in. They line up Robinson on the left side of the lane. Butler on the right side. See if they cross underneath. There they go. Whitaker into Butler, and he's fouled by Greg Bender.
Bailed him out. That's exactly what that was. You know, with only 5 seconds left on the shot clock, no reason to foul on an inbounds pass. All they could have done was probably take a hook shot out there if someone could get off. Vernon Butler's clutch player. This could really hurt the BSC, these foul shots.
Shooting a 1-and-1. He's made 3 of 5 tonight. He's a 69% shooter on the season. Big miss, but Robinson is there. And a foul call. He missed the shot, but he got fouled.
Rousham didn't keep him out of the lane that time.
And Brian Rousham has just fouled out. Well, they lose their leading scorer and rebounder, Brian Rossum, who bites the dust with five fouls. He leaves with 24 points.
He played one heck of a game. He also got 10 rebounds and playing head-to-head against the best defensive center in the country. That's quite a night. He's established himself with his play tonight as being one of the best big men in the country for next year.
Both Rossum and Robinson are juniors. Danny Anderson is back in for the Seahawks. They go to that three-guard offense again. David Robinson is a very inconsistent free throw shooter.
Yes, he is. You sank that one.
He has 22 points, and Navy leads 62-60 with 41 seconds left. Robinson is 6 for 10 at the line tonight.
22 points, 16 rebounds, 3 blocks.
He makes one out of two, and UNC Wilmington has a chance to tie it. 36 seconds remaining in the game, but Ryan Rossum is fouled out. Who do they go to? Very small lineup on the floor for the Seahawks.
Well, they got some good shooters in there. They're also going to look for the outside shot. No one to go to inside.
They're going
to
call a timeout with 21 seconds remaining.
I don't know if that's what Coach Gibson wants, but we'll see when they come back on the court.
Navy has 3 timeouts remaining. UNC Wilmington has 1 left.
I think you got to put at least one big guy in there just to go for the rebound in case the shot is not made.
Got a very small lineup on the floor right now. Let's listen to Paul Evans. Overtime if we have to, and he knows if they go to overtime, he's got an advantage because Brian Rossum is fouled out.
That's exactly right. He does not want to be beaten here, you know, not only give up the basket, but foul someone at the same time.
No three-point play.
I think he's going to go man-to-man. Let's see here. That would be a switch, but no, I guess he's still staying in his zone.
Navy led 60-52, an 8-point lead with 3 minutes left in the game, and UNC Wilmington battled back.
Bender's the biggest player in the game for UNCW at 6'5", 6'6". They've got some good outside cheaters in there, though.
Better not waste too much time. 10 seconds remaining. Sandy Anderson off the mark. Rebound to Springer. 2 seconds left. Springer puts up a prayer. And that's the ball game. And the UNC Wilmington players are devastated. Swoon around the floor. Greg Bender and Sandy Anderson can't believe it. Final score, Navy 62 and UNC Wilmington 60. Paul Evans walking off the floor as Navy has won its 12th consecutive game, but they had a fight on their hands tonight. The first time this evening we've seen him smile. There's our final score. Navy moving on to the championship round. Navy defeating UNC Wilmington 62-60.
Well, what a game. 62-60, the final score. Navy outlasting the upset bid of UNCW. The Seahawks having nothing to hang their heads about this evening, playing the midshipmen ranked 19th in the nation in the Associated Press poll this week. A team that dominated the Seahawks in 2 regular season games. Tonight, the Seahawks coming in with a great game plan. Mel Gibson having the Hawks use the 45-second shot clock, not being in a hurry. It worked to perfection. Brian Rossum, a great night against David Robinson. He indeed did deserve to be on the first team All-CAA. Tonight at 11 o'clock, we'll have a complete report on the game from Gene Motley in Fairfax, Virginia. We've enjoyed bringing this game to you. Once again, the final score, UNCW losing to Navy in a heart stopper, 62-60 in the CAA semifinals. We now join Hardcastle.